Hello everyone, welcome back. In my previous video I've made this centerpiece for that candle holder. It's made from a walnut log, and in this video I'm gonna continue making the legs. The legs are going to be made from acacia wood. It's a very strong wood and I like it. And also I'm gonna drill the holes for the legs. So if you want to see the rest of the video, stay tuned. Thanks. Now in order to measure where the legs have, where the holes for the legs have to be drilled, I draw a line all the way for the center. I've measured the diameter and then I've split to three. And now I'm gonna make this line disappear again. Okay, so now I'm left only with those marks. I'm gonna go to the drill press and make those 45 degree holes. But first I'm gonna go ahead and make the legs. The idea is I have to make the entry point 35 millimeter approximately, like the drill bit, the force drill bit.
Change of plan.
Thank you.
it's almost cut through it. I'm gonna go finish the cut with
this machine. I'm gonna finish the cut. Came out nice, I say. I like them, and I'm gonna proceed with making the holes in the center piece. In order to make these holes, I had to reposition my bench trail in a rather weird position, I think. The problem is that I couldn't lay it along the workbench because it's too long. And it wouldn't permit me to make a 45 degree angle hole. So you see, this is lowered way below the level of the workbench. Only this way I could make a 45 degree hole, and I hope it works after all this work to ruin this, but no worries, whatever it is, I'm gonna post it if I screw this up. That's life, no? Okay, let's see what happens. I hope I don't ruin this.
working, but there's a little too much vibration. I wish I could crank this down to reduce the vibration, but I don't have a C-clamp that long. It moved the position a little bit, but now it's not going anywhere. This time I'm gonna put on some glasses and I'm taking safety measures. I made it. This time I'm taking it closer to see what's happening.
Portion with when the bit catches the hardest, quite dangerous. So I'm gonna push as low as I can downwards. From this point on, it seems like it's more stable. From the moment that that tip got inside there, so I'm gonna continue another 4-5 millimeters, and then I'm gonna lower the speed. This was the third one.
Okay.
This was to be expected. The legs don't go all the way because of this edge here. So I have to flatten this out in order to get the legs more inside. All three of them. Other than that, it's all good. from up here it looks okay, it looks nice. I have almost ruined one, but I think a little bit of wood dust and glue will make the trick. This one here is a little bit loose. This one is okay, and this one also okay. So it's not that bad in the end. But this is not the end. I still have to cut a little bit of the tip of the legs and make the upper part. But I think in the next video, I don't want to make this one too long. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I hope you like my idea with drilling those 45 degree holes on a length like this. So bye, see you next time.